How's it going, guys? I'm your host, Debs04066, and welcome back to this week's DragonFable release. So this week, we have a relatively small release. We got some new haircuts and houses inside the forum of Nieboheim. There's also some rebalancing for Necromancer Soulweaver and Master Soulweaver. So check out the design notes later to find out what are the changes. But before that, let's head over to the forum and see if we can to take a look at the new haircuts and the shops. So I'm going to switch over to an armor that allows you to see my hair. And I know previously I forgot to show off the Kenna the Barbarian's new haircut inside the Inn at the Age of Time. So do forgive me for that, but you guys can probably go and take a look at it yourself. So recently, Deja's birthday items, I think they've been removed already. Yep, they've been removed, but previously there was an exploit whereby you can sell the items for more dragon coins than you were buying it for, allowing people to basically get dragon coins. But obviously you shouldn't do that, that's an exploit. People who have done that already had their dragon coins revoked, and since this is just a very small matter, the staff has decided not to take action. So let's go and take a look at what haircut they have. Long and black, braids, citizen plus citizen, long rings, fade away, stylish buzz cut, tight back, long and back braids. Yep, so that's it. Not such a huge fan of any of those haircuts, so I'm just going to pass that up. Now let's take a look at the house shops. There are new houses and house items as well, so I'm pretty excited to see. Nope. Where are the house shops? Oh, there it is. Houses. Classic Nieboheim house does not have the option to change backgrounds, and an obsidian home. A house turned to obsidian. Oh, can I actually buy? Okay, so I'll just buy both of them to show them off to you guys. One is 100k, one is 10k gold. So, oh, now you can equip different houses. Very nice. So let's, obsidian home is equipped already. Let's equip that. So let us head on over to our house to see how the obsidian house looks like. Okay. Interesting. Let us see. Okay, there are some slots here that you can add items to. Okay, it comes with its own soundtrack as well, which is pretty nice. This is a pretty standard house. Oh, there's quite a lot of rooms here. Wow, actually quite a lot of rooms, but it's a very basic design. So, yep, there's that. Right, so let us head back on over to the forum. Okay, so let's run the other way instead. I think it's faster. Yep, it is. Okay, so now let us sell, equip the Nieboheim house and sell this because I don't want that obsidian home. Let's go to house now to see how it looks like. So the Nieboheim home. Oh wow. Okay, this is actually pretty nice. It's really nice. Okay, so let's manage. Let's see. Okay. Wow. Looks really grand inside. Almost like a palace of sorts. Okay. You have a few rooms. They all look the same. And that's about it. I sort of wish there was a staircase or something leading up to the second level so you can see some other stuff, but oh wells. Yes, that's fine. So we'll actually keep the Nieboheim house, but I still prefer my Dragon Graph's house instead. So equip that. Or should I say, I'm using Dragonlock Castle, yeah. No. I prefer my Dragonlock Castle, so equip that. And then, that's all for the houses. I think the Nieboheim house is worth getting. It's 100k gold. Obsidian house, doesn't look really nice to me. It's only 10k gold. So next up, let's see, Azavaran house items, white bush, okay. Magical Ornate Pillar. Wow, that actually looks nice. ornate pillar. Magical one obviously looks better. Obsidian mist, that looks nice as well. Nieboheim window, that looks pretty nice. Sandcastle, okay, that's not bad. Hanging vines, obsidian family R. And obsidian family L. One is left, one is right. Tapestry of Pelicoa. Whoa, I think this is our background, so 65 DCs. Yeah, overall I do quite like the background, so you guys can get that if you like. Honey column. Wow, okay. Spilled salt. Okay, this is actually quite nice as well. It's animated, so shapeless statue. Wow. Okay. Looks kind of weird, but okay, guess that looks pretty cool. Power of socks. And model potion maker. Whoa! Wow, this is a really nice one. I may actually want to get that model potion maker. Can I buy more house slots? Okay, so I can buy more house slots for... Do I really need more house slots? Where can I put the model potion maker? Right, so all my houses, all my items have become unequipped. Looks like there really isn't much place for me to put the house items anymore. So, I think we'll just keep it as that. I don't think I have 45 spaces anyways, so... Yeah, so now let's check out the balancing. Okay, so first up we have Necromancer. So Necro, it's sort of weak after the previous nerf, and now Verdi has decided to buff it again. So Fear Ward, okay, which is the shield, it applies 180 BPD up from 140. In my opinion, it doesn't make a big difference. Okay, so duration increased to 3 turns up from 2 turns. Okay, that's a buff. Cooldown increased to 6 turns up from 4 turns. Okay. That is of course to offset the duration. So yeah, I think Fear Ward, that's pretty nice. I would see it as a buff definitely. Life tap, another buff, increase. It now heals 15% max HP instead of 14% max HP. 1% isn't going to make a big difference, so that's pretty meh. Cooldown reduced to 6 turns, down from 9 turns. Okay, that's pretty nice to see. So you can heal more often, and that means you can heal more. So life tap, really good buff right there. So that's all for the Necromancer changes. Next up, Soulweaver, the very controversial class that needs a lot of, I would say nerfs because of how strong it is. But of course, I do like strong classes, and there's the issue of power creep and all that. So they have no choice but to nerf it. So let's see what the nerfs. So Verli said, these changes are intended to make Soulweaver more generalized, boosting offense while reducing some overbearing defensive options. So the shield, increased to 10 turns up from 6, and cooldown of base AGs increased to 5 turns up from 3. Wow, okay, that is a huge nerf. So you won't be able to shield up as often. That is a very, very big nerf, and wow, one of the best skills of Soulweaver to date. Oh well, I guess we can sort of expect the shield nerf to come soon anyways. Battle impact, Beltail version crit bonus of attack increased to 100 up from 50. Wow. Now Beltail version total damage increased by 50%. Wow, that is a huge buff for the damage of Valor Impact, so that's nice to see. Concentration crit bonus increased to 200 up from 20. Oh my gosh, that is crazy about it as well. So 20 crit isn't gonna give you anything, but 200 crit, that basically means all your attacks are going to crit. Finally, you have a proper reason to use concentration, so wow, that is crazy. Next we have Ceiling Slash, basically infinite 30% damage reduction was insane. So boost effect reduced to minus 15 down from minus 30. So the mana cost, the cooldown turns, is everything is still going to be the same, but the boost effect is basically half. So it's only going to be minus 15% damage, no longer minus 30% damage. Next, repentance dot damage increased to 100% weapon damage up from 33%. Wow, that is a lot as well. Base damage increased by 10% per hit. Oh my goodness. MP cost increased to 60 up from 40. Okay, that's to offset the damage buff. But I guess 20 more mana doesn't really... isn't going to make much of a difference, especially at max level. Of course, it might in the long run, but I don't see affecting my character right now. Next, Purge, MP cost increased to 30, up from 15, so MP cost is doubled for this. Purge, it's good against boss fights, against regular monsters, not so much, so... And you probably won't be using this every other turn, so the MP cost, I'll say it's negligible. Next, Soul Slice was a little too powerful against bosses, but not really useful. Otherwise, these changes bring it more in the, with other instant kill skills. So threshold for annihilation increased to 50%, up from 15%. So now you're going to apply the annihilation dot from 50% instead of at 15% health. But that being said, you can only finish off enemies with max HP less than half of your max HP. In my opinion, that makes annihilation useless. Only good for normal questing against bosses. It's completely useless because you won't find a boss that has less than half of your max HP. So yeah, it's pretty much a useless skill now. If annihilation fails now, apply Soul Taunt, a 300% dot for one turn. Both Soul Taunt and annihilation now require you to hit your enemy to take effect. So previously, annihilation dot will it's an auto hit on your enemy regardless of whether or not you manage to land the hit. And I think this is too much of a nerf for Soul Slice because Soul Slice is essentially now a useless skill. If your enemy already has less than half of your max HP to begin with, on top of that, you need to take the enemy down to only 50% HP to trigger annihilation. What is the point of annihilation then? And you apply Soul Taunt 300% dot for one turn. That will essentially almost kill the enemy anyway. So half of my max HP is about 1.3k, and then half of that for annihilation to take place is about 700 plus HP. One attack I am doing, like, depending on what skill I'm using, I'm doing 200 damage on average, together with my pet. So, what is the point of using this skill, when the enemy is almost going to die already? And what is the point of Soul Taunt, when annihilation will kill it anyway? So, there's no way annihilation, even if annihilation fails, Soul Taunt, it basically just acts as a backup. So, either way, I think this skill is sort of useless. They might have over-nerfed it, and it sort of takes away the whole annihilation cooldown thing of the skill. So next up, we have Soul Burst. Now it tries to apply stun alongside mana burn. That's good. Stun effect reduced to 1 turn, down from 2 turns. Okay, that is a huge nerf. Cooldown increased to 6 turns, up from 4 turns. There is another small nerf as well. So even though it always tries to apply stun, the stun is now only 1 turn. I think this is a... I would say this is a buff because now you always have a chance to stun it rather than previously you do not know whether or not you are able to stun the monster. So I will call this a buff instead of a nerf. Next, the biggest change of them all, Soul Sing. Veiltail Soul Sing previously did not require meditation to use. As a result, Veiltail Soulweaver also missed out on the Calm and Inner Peace boost in exchange for a massive burst. With the changes to other offensive skills, Veiltail Sing no longer needs to be the only burst skill. Okay, I guess that's reasonable. Removed, I'm here notification on Belt Sing, that doesn't do anything. Okay, Belt Sing now requires meditation inner peace. So whether or not you have Veiltail Soulweaver equipped, you will need to do the meditation thingy which gives you the boost, which means it is essentially a longer cooldown for Soul Sing. But that being said, Belt Sing damage increased by 25% per hit. That is going to be a lot of damage on top of the meditation and inner boost bonuses. Wow, you're going to do way more than 1000% damage. That is, of course, it's on a longer cooldown. Normal full sync damage increased by 35% per hit. Okay, that's a buff to the original Soulweaver. Come and inner beast boost buff decreased to 20%, down from 30%. Okay, so this, I would say, it's a buff, obviously, in terms of damage, but you are set on a longer cooldown, and I would say I'd like to see big numbers, so I see this as a buff, and this will be amazing against boss, even more so than what it originally was. And even though you don't have the one-hit kill potential anymore, I think it's still a great skill, and it's not completely broken, so I like that. So all in all, I think Soulweaver, they are trying to make it more offensive-orientated rather than defensive-orientated. Most of the defense skills all had a nerf, whereas the offensive skills, they are mostly getting a buff. Last but not least, Master Soulweaver, finally a buff to Buster Soulweaver, because with Bailtail Soulweaver, Buster Soulweaver is almost obsolete if you ask me, so let's see what changes they made. More powerful shield than Soulweavers, but less uptime. So cooldown decreased to 6, down from 8, that's good to see. MP cost increased to 25, up from 15, that's okay. Because MP cost, 10 MP isn't going to make a big difference. Valor Impact, as Buster Soulweaver does not have concentration, Valor Impact is not a guaranteed crit. Crit bonus or attack increased to 200, up from 50, wow, okay, that's crazy. MP cost increased to 25, up from 20, again, 5 MP isn't going to make a big difference, so both Soul Agents and Valor Impact, I'll see them as a buff. Meditation, MP heal increased to 15% of max MP, up from 10%, that is a straight up buff, which is good. Soul Seal, now requires the attack to hit the enemy to apply effects, that is obviously a nerf, it's no longer auto hit, so that is kind of sad. Reckoning, damage increased by 7% base damage per hit. Wow, really good. So a buff here. Repentance, not damage increased to 100% up from 33%. Oh my god, that's a crazy buff as well. Damage increased by 10% of base damage per hit. MP cost increased to 60 up from 40. And now requires you to hit the enemy to apply the dot. I always thought repentance, you had to hit the enemy to apply the dot. I didn't know that you can hit the enemy, you can miss all your hits and then still apply the dot. So this I would still say is a buff simply because you are getting a lot more damage out of it. And Purge, MP cost increased to 30 up from 15, that's fine with me. Soul Banish, same as Annihilation basically, or same as Soul Slice. Exactly the same effects without the Soul Taunt thingy, because you don't have the 300% dot. So that's kind of weird. Why does Soul Slice have it on regular Soulweaver, but Master Soulweaver does not have the Soul Taunt? So maybe Verly forgot to add this in, I'm not really sure. Soul Vacuum always tries to apply the boost reduction effect along with the stun. Okay, that's nice. So it's an auto hit down, and Remorse cooldown reduced to 1, down from 3. And because it increased to 40, up from 25. Wow, cooldown reduced to 1. Okay, so I just checked the forums. It looks like Soul Banish, you do get minus 100 bonus for your enemy for 2 turns, I believe. So yeah, that sort of makes up for the difference between Soul Slice and Soul Banish. So yes, Soul Banish is better, so I stand corrected on what I said earlier before. Remorse is basically a multi-hit skill. Cooldown reduced to 1, that's not going to make a big difference. I'd rather they just make the cooldown 0, because there are classes with multi-hit skills that do not have a cooldown. And I surely believe that multi-hit skills should not have a cooldown, because well, against multiple enemies, that would really come in useful. So that's all for class changes. Let us know what you think on the forums and on Twitter. As always, your feedback is valuable. And Epoch now has new art visible when equipping the Corrupted Doom cassette. Please note that skill change and effects are not complete yet. This update is only visual. Skill changes and effects are coming soon. So let us take a look at Epoch. Let's look at the new art, and of course, shout out to Jeremy Dean Gawai once again. Thank you very much for helping me get the calendar code, so now I'm able to showcase this to you guys. So let us move the Corrupted Doom cassette into my inventory and equip it to show you what the new Doom Pop looks like. Yes, I am down with a very bad flu, as you guys can tell from my nasally voice, so I apologize for that. So this is the new Doom Pog. I know you guys can't really see, so I'm trying to get a more zoomed in version. I can't really see properly on my screen either. So it's definitely a bit different from what I've seen on those Twitter. Okay, a little bit different, and wow, I like it. I really like it. Though I wish there was a bit more red. Maybe make the eyes on the skull glow red or something like that. That would be nice to see. And still keeping in line the rainbow effects. Of course, it's view here, as you guys can see. The movement cogwheel at the bottom of your character's feet is now more yellowish and ominous with a more darker theme, similar to green. So next, last but not least, some minor bug fixes and changes. Left button on the Dragon Challenges board now properly loops around due to unforeseen issues with guests and Doomcrawler challenges. Guests will be removed when fighting the Doomcrawler from the challenge board. This challenge is not reflected in the AARGH system of the fight. However, this is a temporary measure until the source of the issue can be investigated and fix the few issues where confirmation boxes will have incorrect titles. So all in all, a very small release. I think the Soulweaver house items are worth getting. Haircuts, not so nice in my opinion. The houses, maybe you can get the Nieboheim house if you like it. And yeah, the class balance changes, I like all of them, to be honest. I think they are trying to make Soulweaver a much more offensive orientated class, but I don't really like that they took away so much of his defensive power. So obviously Master Soulweaver and Necromancer needed a buff, and that was nice to see. So that's my opinions for this week's release. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe to my channel for more such future content. Till next time, this has been DragonFable 0466. Peace out.